Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode. Today we're going to talk about the full timeline of Corepunk. What has happened since the game was actually officially announced till today? What do we know about the game? Not like all the specific details, but what have happened since we got the, well, basically the announcements back in the 10th December till today. So what have happened in all this, you can say, almost 1 year. We are almost in December again, so that basically means it is almost 1 year ago Corepunk was officially announced. Let's go through it and let's see the full timeline of what has happened so far. Going back to the 10th December, Corepunk officially announced their game on a trailer showing on IGN's YouTube page. Basically, the video didn't get uploaded on their own YouTube site, but it started on IGN for like getting a little boost. Also, they released 3 articles on their website the same day, the 10th December, one called Meet the Artificial Core Team, basically linking to the website called Artificial Core, also showing concept of Corepunk's culture, so they showed a bit of, you can say, art of the game, and also they made a post called Welcome to Corepunk, just talking a bit about Corepunk and what the passion about the game is. The next update we get is the 20 December. We got an article on the Corepunk website called Lore and Quest First Details, stating a bit about the lores, the factions, the 4 factions we got, and some of the questing in the game. Just like setting the same, you can say that basically they're saying this is how the game is, you know, this is the factions and so on. The 24th December, you know, the Christmas Day, or that's the Christmas Day at least here, we got Corepunk News 1. This video and article was all made because of the community. A lot of people, they raised complaints on the internet about the game speed in the official trailer, saying the game looks, you can say, slow and maybe boring. And they basically made a video saying, hey, you can actually make run faster, attack faster in the game by getting items. So maybe when you create your character in level 1, it will be slow, but as long as you can say in the progress when you get better items and so on, you will be faster and having faster attack, if of course that's the stats you get. Also, behind the scene, what happened that day was they also visited the YouTuber called Dvalin, me. They visited me on Christmas Day and delivered a gift. Actually, they gave me this troll, and he's from the trailer. And they gave me this guy, so thank you a lot for that. But that was also something that happened on the 24th December. No one knew it except me. You know, I knew it when I opened the door and Eugene was standing out there, like, surprised. But first, the 27th December, I was allowed to talk about it, and I made a post on, I made a video about it on YouTube, and also posted it on the official Discord, the Corepunk Discord. That was the 27th. December. Then the 29th December, Corepunk, they released an article and also a YouTube video called Corepunk News 2 Christmas Story. Basically, they're showing a lot of influencers, YouTubers, that is talking about the game and, you know, how happy they are for the game and so on. And then also they show that they are traveling to Denmark, Copenhagen, and driving a long distance for visiting me. And again, I'm pretty honored for that, so that's really cool. So again, thanks for that, Eugene and the team, really appreciate it. But that was, you can say, what happened in December. Then we're coming into January, and in January they announced their content creator program, and the first content creator to join the program that they also gave a shout out in the article was me, Dvalin. And pretty honored to be the first content creator in the program. Of course, the program today isn't really a thing. We just have yellow names on the Discord server, and you see more people is beginning also to get it, but it's probably not something right now, but it's probably something in the future when the game actually comes out and they will have some kind of a program for it. But I also think, you know, in the future it would be harder to get, probably something like that. Also, I was allowed to get some exclusive things. I got some exclusive pictures showing some color schemes and a story. So I was showing these color schemes in the same time I was reading up a story and talking a bit about it. So that you can say that was my first exclusive, well, okay, second if you think about, you know, the troll I got, exclusive thing I got. So pretty exciting. And then the 20th January, so that was the 17th January. So then the 20th January, I got, well, not me, they posted the officially announcement on the website, you know, saying this is the color schemes, this is the story, everyone can read it, and you know, they don't have to see it from my website anymore. Then the 23 January, the content creator Shivo, he created a video where he counted all the trees in the Corepunk trailer. Basically, he counted up to 125 trees. Eugene also later commented that he think this was a cry from the community saying we are starving, we need more about this game. And I also think that was some of the things that triggered the article that we actually got the day after. So I think we can all thank Shivo for actually like pushing the developers to give us more news, because he was basically saying we are bored, now I'm counting your trees. And you know, that's what happens when you're counting trees in a trailer. Then the developers, they begin to focus more on getting out some news, because they know we are hungry. So the 24th January, the day after Shivo posted, on the 23rd January, we got a Corepunk release, we got an article called Concept of Corepunk Culture 2. I mean, it could be, you know, just a fun timing that it's the day after, but Eugene, he commented somewhere on the, either it was on the Discord or the Reddit, where he said that this video of course was funny, but was also a cry for more, that the community needed more content. But basically on the 24th January, they then released this concept of Corepunk Culture, showing a lot of new culture, armor and weapons. It's a pretty cool post. January 28, Corepunk released another article for color schemes for locations and some story sketches, part 2. Also, another content creator got this material the day before, I think it was, and he also was allowed to make a video about it before everyone else. I really tried hardcore to find out who that was, but I couldn't find it. So if you, the content creator out there, did it, you please let me know in the comments, and I will highlight your comment. I'll add it. But yeah, so that was we got some more color schemes, more stories, and also another content creator announcement and video by that. Then we're going into February, and Corepunk released an article showing some Fisher Village concepts. So you know, some villages, some fishings, and also even some fishes, some like beasts and so on. Basically confirming that there's probably coming fishing in this game, maybe. Corepunk also released another thing in February. Actually, February only had 2 articles, so you can say it was a pretty poor month. But again, two posts are pretty good also, I think. So they released another article on the 27th February. And they released an article showing the Yawner city and tech, including a mount. So, you know, they basically showed some art from the faction called the Yawners. Pretty exciting, pretty cool. So it was also pretty good to, you know, receive. Then we're walking into March. And in the 13th March, Corepunk released an article with a long story about the Elanians and how they live with monsters, these blood and gore monsters, and their king. It's pretty exciting article. It was a very long story, but it was definitely worth reading. Another fun thing that happened this day was also that Dvalin, he released a video showing he sent the developers cups with his own logo, and the developers, they answered with an unboxing video showing that basically was shown on Dvalin's channel. I'm talking about Dvalin like he's another person, that's me. So basically I also released a funny video that day showing the developers setting free Eugene, Irene and Bodan, the video director. He's like the person who's like responsible for recording videos and editing videos and so on. He was actually also visiting me on the 24th December holding the camera for Eugene. So it's pretty fun that they made this little video where they unboxed, you can say unboxed my cups. I didn't expect that when I sent them the cups. It was more like a thanks for sending me the troll. I'm sending you some cups you can drink tea or coffee from, or chocolate. So yeah, just a funny little side note going back on the track. The next news we got was in March 19 by Corepunk. They updated us all on the corona situation, or you can call COVID-19. They said that they're reorganizing the company and people will begin to work from home, and of course this will also create some delay because people are not cannot anymore like just walk, jump around and, you know, talk with each other. So that was just a little announcement that I think we pretty much everyone expected, because every one person in the world almost got to work from home, you know what I mean. Then the next thing we got on the 27th March was the official song that they show also in the Corepunk trailer. It's the, you know, the song called When We Stand As One. We will come again. And it's a pretty short lyrics, but it has a pretty cool melody. So I definitely like the song. They released it in three different versions. One in English, and I believe the other one is in Russian, and the third one I'm not 100% sure. Then walking into April, we got the first quarterly update Q1. And in this one, they talked about the gender unlocks, that, you know, you can be a male or female no matter what hero you choose, heroes and masteries. They talked about the new gameplay stream that will be upcoming. They talked about the business model, that it's going to be a pay-to-play game with battle passes and in-game shops. A bit about the world designs and creatures and monsters. That was actually the only thing we got in April, but I think that's pretty okay when you think about it. It was a big article on April, so I think that's fine that this one was the only one we got in April, because it was a big one they have used tons of time to create. Then walking into May, the 11th May, we got another Corepunk, well, we got a news that the Corepunk gameplay video got officially delayed, so you can say that's how it is. But we got the information that the Corepunk gameplay video was delayed, and it will come later on, so we would have to be, you can say, patient. The 18th May, we got some cams to see. You know, they show this article where they show these cams, and it's basically like in a MOBAs where you have these cams around with mobs, and they show these cams that they are also in the game with, like in MOBAs with cams, and they will of course have some higher treasures, but can also be dangerous to, you know, to attack because of open world PvP and stuff like that. Then on the 27th May, so you can say in May, we actually got a lot of different articles, delay, games, and now an announcement. So in the 27th May, we got the announcement that they will be a part of IGN Summer of Gaming, showing exclusive gameplay and also even an interview. It's pretty cool, if you ask me. Then in the next month, the 15th June, IGN Summer of Gaming happened, showing exclusive gameplay from Corepunk and also an interview with Eugene. Also, they released a 15-minute gameplay video beside that, because in the live stream they didn't show the full gameplay. They made a trim version. IGN made a cut down version that was pretty poor made. You know, the video itself, 15-minute from Corepunk, is really good. But the edit that IGN showed in the live stream was pretty bad. But the good thing was they released after the 15-minute full gameplay video. That was definitely worth seeing. In this video, we saw some names from the community on the Discord. We saw the name Dragom, Crimson, Lyofa, and Dan Cobra in the video. They didn't actually play. It's actually the video that I also have running in the background on this video right now, but it's not them playing, it's the developers who just took their names just for highlighting them, and also because there was an Easter egg where you could actually win something, and that you can say that Easter egg gave you your name in this trailer as a thank. So that was the only thing we got in June, but again, that's also a pretty huge thing that they had this. I think they used tons of time to prepare this video and interview for IGN. So I think that's to say it's fine, we only got that in June. Going into August, the 7th August, we didn't actually get any official things from Corepunk, but our dear beloved podcaster called also content creator, streamer, and dad, and gamer, and Birdman, he has a podcast called Corecast. It's a podcast only about Corepunk, and he released episode 8 that I was also a part of, but we had the honor to interview Eugene, the producer of Corepunk, and also Pishek, the lead game designer. It was pretty fun to sit together with those two and, you know, just have a chit chat. We didn't really like kill them with questions about the game. We more had like questions about the journey, what they like to do, what they like to play, you know, just like a really chill and having fun Corecast episode. So thanks to Boast for making that episode and planning all the things, and thanks for being, for I could be a part of that also. Then on the 1st September, we got the quarterly update Q2. So the next quarterly update. This one showed a lot of stuff. It showed a new quest interface. It showed us the coordinator, who's this, the voice behind main quests that helps us. It showed that we can actually jump in this game on the space key. It showed customizations. So when you choose a hero, you can choose like skin color, hair color, faces, so on. They also showed fatalities, so that means when you die, it can actually look different because your character is created with fatalities, so maybe you get like burned or scorched or freezed and so on. Also, they showed us that they are going to be less focusing on gameplay videos because it's basically interrupting the progress of the game, and they have to like shine small pieces of games when they have to make these videos. They said also that they're going to make the closed beta release date. In the article, it actually says right now that it's going to be when about the same day when Corepunk was announced. And that is the 10th December. So I would assume that the closed beta is going to start about the 10th December. Yeah. They also released a Corepunk behind the scene video showing a long time span where they showed, you know, where they announced the game and they like working on the game, and then they're packing all the things together, going home because of Corona and all that. So it's pretty exciting. It was a really heartful, you know, it was a video that was very emotional and could maybe bring someone in teary. So really, really good video. I really enjoyed that one, and I have big respect that they made that, and I'm sure Bowden, he's been recording this video for a very long time. So that was what happened on the 1st September. The 9th September, Corepunk, they had an AMA on Reddit where Eugene and Pishak was basically answering like tons of questions on Reddit. And that was a pretty good one. And I also made a video about all the questions we got answered, but we got a lot of good questions answered on that day. The 16th September, we got a forum post from the developers talking about choosing talent branches. They basically talked about how the talents are, what you have to do when you level up your talents in a spec, and when you get to maximum level, then you can choose another talent spec and level up that talent spec. So basically, you have to level up each talent spec in the game, and it's not like World of Warcraft where you can just switch between talents and already be maxed in each of them. But yeah, you can go and read the forum post if you want. Then the last post we have got from Artificial Core / Corepunk is on the 30 October, where they released a Halloween video showing a lot of more minifigures like the troll I got, but this time it was skeletons. where they like standing around with dark light and, you know, really Halloween themed, and just like a little gimmick where they said happy Halloween everyone. So that is the last thing we have heard from them, is back to the 3rd October. I think it was the 3rd October, wasn't it? If I go to Corepunk official, and if we go all the way down, yeah, it was the 3rd October. So 3rd October, but you can say like really news, it was more back. So officially news was back in September, the 16th. We actually got news about something. But the rumor says that we're going to get news this week or next week, where we are probably getting maybe the quarterly update 3. And also we're going to get the exact close beta date. That's the rumors we got so far. So we will see. So thanks for joining me on this 20-minute journey into the full timeline of Corepunk. And I hope you enjoy this video. If you feel like I missed anything, let me know in the comments, and you know, let us make sure people know what we're talking about. And yeah, else let me know what you think about the video, and fingers crossed that we will very soon be in close beta. I can't wait to play the game and, you know, have fun with you all. Thanks for watching, have a nice evening, and see you in another episode. Peace out.